In a patient presenting with chest pain, dyspnea, or hypotension, the parasternal long and short axis views of the heart can provide significant information about cardiac function at the bedside. To perform this scan, I'm going to use the phased array scanner on the cardiac preset, and I'm going to place it at the left sternal border. I like to break this scan up into several different steps. The first one is window shopping. So by holding the transducer at one angle, I'm going to slide up and down that left sternal border to find the window where the heart appears its brightest through the lung. Once I'm happiest with my window, from here, I'm going to fan for the middle. That means tilting the transducer towards the patient's head or towards his feet to find the valves opening up at their maximal diameter. Once I'm happy with that, I'm going to then just rotate the transducer to find the ventricle open up to its widest width. When I found an image that I really like, with a great window, good opening valves, and the widest possible ventricle, I now can identify the different features of the heart. I see the right ventricle at the top of the screen, the left ventricle at the bottom. I see the aortic outflow tract and the left atrium, and the descending thoracic aorta behind the very bright pericardium. To now reach my parasternal short axis, it's just a simple rotation from the same window towards the patient's left shoulder. And I'll see the left ventricle come into view here as the round donut with the croissant of the right ventricle up on its left. You can see here the mitral valve is right at the window in the middle of the ventricle. And so to get it at the ideal midventricular view, I'm going to slowly just slide the transducer towards the ventricle until I have a nice, round, symmetrically squeezing left ventricle. Once I've scanned through the long and the short axis, I can feel confident on assessing the various features of his cardiac function.